So good morning students. So in the last lecture we were dealing with problems regarding simple harmonic motion. Now we are going to our last topic, which is vibration of mechanical systems. Okay, so each and every system vibrates with respect to its reference position, right? So see, if you see if you tie a rubber band and you are tying it to a wall, and at one end you are holding this string, okay. Now what happens if you vibrate this? That means if you vibrate this, this goes like an oscillations, and see here, from this particle is moving towards here. From one position, this particle is moving up and down with respect to a point. So this is generally, most of the vibrations or some of the vibrations undergoes simple harmonic motions. Okay, see, so vibration of mechanical system generally results when a system is displaced from its position of stable equilibrium. So if I am pulling a string, the particle at each particle will vibrate, will go and return to its position of stable equilibrium. The system tends to return to its equilibrium due to action of restoring force. So why this is restoring to its original position? Due to a restoring force. If you consider a spring, if you pull the spring to one side, if you release the force that you are applying, what happens? It gets back to its position. Why? Because there is a restoring force there. Okay, right. So this restoring force may be an elastic force, as in the case of simple pendulum. Okay, it can be an elastic force or a gravity force in many cases. So if a disturbing force is applied just to start the motion and is then removed from system, leaving it to vibrate itself, system is said to undergo free vibration. So free vibration is nothing but, if this is a pendulum and I am giving a force to move its position from, this is the equilibrium position, and if I give a position force and it is moving upwards, and if I release this force, what happens? The pendulum will come back to its original position and it vibrates. It may vibrate like this, 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 and again it keeps to its equilibrium position. That means this will, a force is applied, then it will oscillate like this. There is no force at this point. So this oscillation is reduced and at last it will stop. Okay, so the vibration in which the external force is removed is called as free vibration. If a disturbing force is applied, initially the force is applied just to start the motion and is then removed from system, leaving it to vibrate by itself. So it is vibrating by itself without any applied force. Even if you throw out your applied force, it vibrates. That sort of vibration is called as free vibration. If the disturbing force acts at periodic intervals on the system, system is said to undergo forced vibration. Here also, if you consider a pendulum at each position, I mean, so this is vibrating from here to here, and at this point I am regularly applying force. Dish, dish, will go like this. Okay, so if I am regularly applying force, then it is called as forced vibration. The time interval required to complete one cycle of motion is called time period of vibration, which we have already discussed. Number of cycles per unit time is called frequency. See, these sorts of things, they can ask for 2 marks or 5 marks or for smaller marks. Okay, that's why I am restating all these things. Okay, number of cycles per unit time is called frequency. F is equal to 1 by T. Okay. The displacement of system from its position of equilibrium is called amplitude of vibration. This amplitude, all these terms we already discussed, you just recollect it. Okay, the frequency free vibration is called as natural frequency. So if a system is vibrating in free vibration, that means you have the applied forces is not there, okay, then that vibration is called, without an applied force, is called natural frequency. Any resistance to vibration of a system is called damping. So while if it is vibrating, you are applying a force other than that applied force, then it is called as damping. So this sine wave will show you what are all the terms that we have discussed. Okay, this is a displacement time graph, in which that means a particle is vibrating, particles are vibrating and it is getting back. Okay, like, so the maximum point at which it goes is called as amplitude. This is the mean position, extreme position. This is extreme position in the trough, and this is extreme position in the crest. Okay, so time period is the total oscillation for one cycle, right? So this is called as time period. Okay, so considering a free vibration of a spring, its displacement time curve can be plotted as shown in the figure. Okay, this is of a spring, it can be of pendulum also. Okay, now you are going to say some terms regarding the frequency, time period, etc. Frequency is nothing but number of vibrations per second. If the frequency is 2 cycles per second, that means there are 2 vibrations per second, that's all. Okay, now time period is nothing but the time required to complete one cycle. That means 1 by F. Tp is nothing but 1 by F, or F is equal to 1 by Tp. So if frequency is 2 cycles per second, time period will be 1 by 2 second. So F is equal to 1 by Tp. Okay. Now, another important thing, the basic elements of a vibrating system. Normally all vibrating system has 3 main elements. One is inertial element, compliance element and damping element. I will explain these terms. So first one is inertial element. This consists of mass, inertia, etc. That means, you know, the inertial element, inertia force, or what happens, what will lead to an inertia force? That is mass. Okay, that you know from F is equal to ma, and in case of rotational motion it is I alpha. So I is the inertial element in case of rotational motion, and mass is the is that of translation. Okay, now compliance element is nothing but it complies with a steady force to produce a corresponding steady deformation. Compliance elements such as springs are capable of conserving energy. So those which are conserved with energy is called as compliance element. Compliance element must return to its equilibrium position when applied force is removed. Spring force. So this is as simple as that. So it's the case of a restoring force, what is here telling about. So motion of compliance element is governed by F is equal to kx, or Cx in some textbooks and some common platforms, you will say F is equal to Cx. So here in case of spring, F is equal to Kx in translation motion. That means if in case of a spring and all. And M is equal to K theta when it is a rotational motion. Okay. So here F is the force, K is stiffness in case of a spring, X is linear displacement, moment, m is a moment, theta is angular displacement. Okay, now the third one is damping. Now any resistance to motion is called damping. So it's associated with the dissipative action. That means the vibration, the free vibration has been stopped here. So mass and elasticity of components of damper leads to zero. And damping element stays where it is when applied force is removed. Here the damping force, force is equal to Cv in translational motion and C omega in case of rotational motion, where C is called as the damping coefficient. Okay, so these are all things that you might have learned in your physics itself. So I'm not explaining it to that extent. Okay, so undamped free vibration. When a vibrating body of a system has to and fro motion along a straight line, vibration is called linear vibration or longitudinal vibration. So if you analyze a spring system, it consists of a spring which is attached to a mass. So this mass will have a weight, that means due to gravity it will show a gravity force, so mg, and there is a restoring force k delta or kx, whatever it is. Okay, so mg minus k delta will give you zero at equilibrium. Okay, now if x be the maximum distance, that means the amplitude, right? So it can be pulled up to a point of x such that it restores to its, it can restore its force, right? That is called as amplitude. So x is, it can be pulled or pushed. It can be pulled up to x or it can be pushed up to x. Okay, so here in this case, if x be the maximum distance, it restores the same distance x backwards also. Okay, so when body is at a distance x below equilibrium, that means this is the equilibrium motion. If the body is in distance x below here, the spring has reached here. Okay, this was the equilibrium position and you pull this and it has reached, it traveled a distance x and it has reached this position. Okay, the body is in motion and net force is mg minus k into x plus delta. So delta is nothing but this distance, the distance up to which it can go, right? That means delta is without mass a spring which can be extended, that is called as delta. So this becomes x plus delta. So when a mass is put, it's k delta and it is moving a distance x, so k into x plus delta, that's all. Okay, so mg minus k into x plus delta is equal to ma. This is not in equilibrium, so the here total force is ma. Here the total force is zero. Okay, since it is in equilibrium, but here it's not like this. If you push the system, this will oscillate, this will have an acceleration, so ma. And from here, if you give mg minus kx minus k delta is equal to m into dou square x by dou t square. Okay, since mg is equal to k delta cancels, minus kx is equal to m into d square x by dt square. Okay, now d square x by dt square plus, you are rearranging this thing, plus m by k, k by m into x is equal to 0. This becomes a differential equation and this is called as equation of motion of a vibrating body. This you might have studied in your first module in physics. Okay, I think it's first module in vibrations. Okay, anyway, so for simple harmonic motion, d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x, that means acceleration. And here it is d square x by dt square is minus k by m into x. Okay, so omega square is equal to k by m, omega is equal to root of k by m, so f is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of k by m. So this derivation is very important and this is the expression for natural frequency. So they can ask to find out how you derive an expression to find out the natural frequency of undamped free linear vibration. Okay, So this small derivation is very important from here to here. Okay, fine. So if you analyze a spring mass model system, there will be some terms that can be very useful while doing the problems. Okay, so in the next lecture I'll be dealing with the spring mass model system and some problems. With that we'll be concluding our engineering mechanics session, and we'll go and revise the lessons that we have learned. Okay, thank you.